Ladies and gentlemen, yo, guys, this is the Smokeyhead Record Movie Show, and my pick for tonight is Above the Law.
Oh, Steven Seagal movie.
Steven Seagal, man.
Yeah, I gotta tell you, man.
The keto fans will love
this movie. When you first picked it, I was like, what are you thinking?
I was excited because that was my favorite movie.
Me too. I enjoyed it.
And then when I watched it, well, I appreciate Steven Seagal, you know. Yes. I always did. So I was like, all right. It's been a long time. I'll play along.
I enjoyed this movie.
Can't help it.
Yes. Check it out. It was definitely like, it was kind of like the beginning of like the resurgence of martial arts movies.
Right.
You got Jean-Claude and all
that. Jean-Claude
Van
Damme.
So, yes. You know, it's very, very 80s.
Oh, yeah. Every action star had their
cameo.
Niche, you know, yeah. Like he was a keto.
Well, the best thing about this movie is Pam Grier.
Yes.
loves himself, some Foxy Brown.
Hell yeah, man.
I love Pam Grier. Everybody loves the Pam Grier.
You can't love her. I only do.
She's fine. I claim her.
So check it out. Our episode is Above the Law, starring Steven Seagal. Roll the trailer.
Nico Toscani, he's a covert agent trained to survive in Vietnam. He has a master 6-degree black belt in Aikido. And family in the mafia. He's a cop.
Stop the car!
With an attitude.
Do you know why I love you? You don't live the way other people live.
You're officially suspended, this guy.
The feds come in, the door's closed, nobody hears, smells, or sees anything.
One man.
You just made number 4 on the most wanted list.
One obsession.
I want to be number 1.
One rule.
You guys think you're above the law. You ain't above mine.
Above the Law.
All right, welcome to another episode of Smokeyheads Retro Movie Show. Right, here we go. Yes, I'm your host, Groovy New. And to the right of me is my brother from the same mother.
I'm going to tell you that. Your brother.
Related.
Yeah.
Scrappy J.
Hello, thank you. Welcome.
Don't stick to that name. That's his new name now. We're just trying to get a little radio name kind of going.
Yeah, see how it fits.
He wanted Hot J. We're like, nah.
Oh, apparently Sexy J was taken.
Look over here, laughing to the left is Chopz, Mr. Chopz, the Chopster.
A.K.A. Lamb Chopz, A.K.A.
All right, man.
Don't forget to like us and subscribe. Let's just start off with that, you know, definitely, before we take you on this journey of our movie of the day.
It's been going pretty good so far. This is the fifth one we're recording, man.
Yeah, which means about the 10th episode.
Yeah, and I got 4 in the can. All right, so let's get to our movie, man. Today's movie is Chopz's pick, so if you don't skip, blame it on him.
Well, let's just remember where he's rating number 5s. So, I'm just saying.
He's not going to let that go, man. He's fucked up, man.
He's like, we changed names since then. It's different now.
So I actually went out and bought this one because it was a triple threat set. I don't know.
Yeah, we're not gonna talk about me getting made fun of. But,
holy crap, man.
My Goonies.
And I told you that was Miguel. That wasn't me.
Yeah.
Here it is. So it's the one on the top, Above the Law. I keep looking over there. It's this one.
Yeah, no.
Yeah, so it also came with Under Siege and Under Siege 2. I remember finally liking all 3 of those movies growing up. So I'm dying to see Under Siege 2, 1 and 2 again.
I remember Under Siege liking.
Under Siege 2, yeah. That was the ship.
Yeah.
Yeah, so Steven Seagal. Steven Seagal, like I said, Chopz picked it. Let's see, Chopz. Yeah, give us our numbers that you crammed.
Well, do you want to give us the synopsis first? Oh, do we have it? Actually, I think it was just like a one-liner. A CIA operative from Vietnam. All right. You know, foil's bad. Something like that.
But if I can use the tagline,
you think you're above the law, but you're not above mine.
I'll be honest, just as the movie's beginning, I know we got to get to the numbers, but just as the movie's beginning and he starts just kicking everybody's ass, and I'm just like, this guy thinks he's like above the law, and I'm like, actually, that's the name of the title. I was like, okay, proceed.
I actually, there's a scene in that movie that happens later on too, I'm like, now he's above.
Whoa, that's expensive. It must have been that car flip.
Could have used the Kabuki man.
Yeah, I was just about to say.
Actually, was that you talking about the truck that flipped over?
Oh, I was just joking. No, I was just joking.
No, but that truck that looked like an ice cream truck.
It was, but with a siren
sound. Coming from it. Where the fuck is the siren?
I was going to say, I don't see a siren on it either. I even looked in the windshield just in case they had one of those, movable ones.
The growth for moving $18,000.
$18,000? No, $18 million.
I was about to say.
The movie made a lot of money. That's why he became a superstar. It was his first movie.
Yeah. I mean, you definitely doubled it.
Just to remind you, too, cocaine was a really big drug in the 80s.
Cocaine was a hell of a drug.
What was he at? What was it?
The opening with $2 million.
Yeah, that sounds about right, yeah.
Also, how do you think they play? Well, playing on the radio, get this one. Man in the Mirror, Michael Jackson.
Nice.
You know?
Wow.
1988.
That's the bad album.
You know
that's
how long it took me to realize he was talking about? I was the man in the mirror.
Good enough. God darn it, people like that.
Oh, man.
You can't go on with MJ.
Yeah.
I love it. I love that album. That album was a
good album. Yeah, good album.
All right, let's get that cast going on here.
All right, so, we got directed by Andrew Davis.
So, very good director, which I'm surprised he did this one, because he did The Fugitive. I watched that a couple of months ago, and that fucking movie holds up like a movie.
Yeah, I've seen it recently.
Excellent movie.
Harrison Ford is classic. So
he also did Under Siege 1.
He can do no wrong.
Okay. Well, you know,
90 something, mid 90s.
Oh, yeah.
Mid to the early 90s. Okay. Another big one. Oh, the one with Arnold Schwarzenegger, Collateral Damage.
Oh, okay.
Closer to South America.
Yeah.
He did a lot of good action flicks, right? Prominent director.
That's it then. And then we got the writing credits.
Oh, he did Code of Silence. That's what got him the job.
Oh, okay.
Code of Silence is Chuck Norris' movie.
Yeah.
And I'll talk about the other guy that was in it, too.
Okay, so we got the writing credits, which was Andrew Davis and Steven Seagal.
Steven Seagal and his ego.
Yeah, exactly.
You can tell which parts he wrote.
Oh, my God. Forget it. Yeah, wait till we get into it. I don't think I've ever wanted to tear apart a movie so violently. like a rabbit. Just flying everywhere, but and then we got the screenplay by Stephen Pressfield, Ronald Sassette and Andrew Davis, the director and writer. Then we got the cast, of course, Steven Seagal and his ego.
Nico!
And then of course the
how fucking corny was it too, talking about ego. He's like, he was trying to do a Rocky thing, where he just walks down the street and everybody's like, hey Nico! Yeah, the little kid's best. Hi Nico!
I tell you, I'm wearing a cool Nico shirt.
Yeah. He sees the drug dealers, he's talking to him, whatever. He's like, all right, you stay out of trouble, all right? And then also he gets jumped by a whole bunch of Hispanic people.
He was like, well, those weren't the same ones on that corner.
You messing with my people around the neighborhood. I was like, I'm just talking with them.
Yeah, right.
Cool, man.
I'd be like, oh yeah? Oh, can I buy that?
Also, too, if you listen to us, sometimes there's little things that you can hear in the crowd. They're just saying some really funny shit.
Yeah, I actually caught that,
like the cops are coming over there. Hey, man, my license like that. Why are you driving on the top of a hood?
Oh, that's awesome.
All right, so
and then we got the classic, beautiful Pam Grier.
Pam Grier.
You know?
Pam freaking Grier.
Oh, you know?
Coffee. freaking Foxy Brown, White Mama, Black Mama. That one didn't hold up as well. I watched that recently. I didn't like that one. Because Pam Grier is also Jackie Brown.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Which is one of my top underrated Quentin Tarantino movies. Yeah. A lot of people are like, I don't really care for that. I could watch that every time it comes on. It's just, she's amazing. Freaking Robert Forster is amazing in that. All right, sorry.
Yep, yep.
When it comes to Quentin,
I calm down, buddy. Calm down. It's okay. It's okay. We'll do coffee next. Oh, no, I'm sorry. That's at 70. Sorry.
No, I meant the coffee I drank.
Yeah. What's it called? Then we got Henry Silva.
He was on a lot of bad guy movies.
Yeah, if you see his face, you know.
Have you not learned to pause after you say your name? Because you know I'm going to say something about it.
Well, I didn't want to lease a dead ass, so I was giving you that second. You didn't feel it. I was like, okay.
He was the bad guy in Code of Silence. But the one scene I loved was Henry Silva goes into this room. He's like a real badass. In this room. Better than he is in this one. Because that ending, I was like, what the fuck was that?
I actually rewound it because I was like, what did I miss? I said, yeah, I was like, I think I looked down at like a text or something like that. I looked up and I was like, what happened? Where did I miss? I was like, I rewound it. I was like, no, that really. That's it.
So Henry Silva, I was talking about, he was in Code of Silence. So he walks into the room and this guy's doing cocaine and he slipped through a straw. And Henry Silva fucking smashes his head in the fucking straw right into his nose like that. It's an awesome scene. It always stuck with me.
And that's why I never tried it, man. I'm always afraid someone's going to come from behind and smack it. You know? And then we got Ron Dean, you know?
Nah.
You see what I'm saying?
Supposedly, I don't think he has to go through all of them. Supposedly, he's in all of Andrew Davis's movies.
You know, and right. Then we got Sharon Stone. I didn't even realize she was in it. You know?
I missed her in the credits in the beginning. I must have blinked. Because when I saw her, I was like, is that Sharon Stone? Get the fuck out of here. It was before Basic Instinct. She didn't get popular until Basic Instinct.
Yeah,
she did a lot of B-movies. And like, what was that one? Alan Quatermain, Lost City of Gold.
Oh, wow.
King Solomon's Mind.
I didn't even realize she was in it.
Oh, my God. I saw that recently. It's so bad.
It was a good thing I don't remember it, huh?
Yeah. What? King Solomon's Mind. So much blue screen. It's ridiculous.
Really?
Yeah. It looks so fake.
King Solomon's.
Not the blue screen. What do you call that? When the projecting.
Oh, okay. So I was going to say.
On the back. Remember how, like, in the old days, we used to drive a car and he's having a
I was going
to
say, wow, in the 80s, they did blue screen. I can only imagine what that pioneering must have looked like.
So he's hanging off a freaking rope and everything, and there's like crocodiles chomping at him. It looks so bad. It's like a National Geographic freaking footage.
That's funny.
Dodger Corman did that. That's why. Oh, no, it was Golden Globe or something.
Okay. And then, I guess Chelsea Ross, you know. Chelsea Russ. Yeah, Nelson Fox.
Forgive Jay.
What are you talking about?
So, fucking driving me crazy at home because he's got that mouth. He's got a big mouth. I'm like, I freaking know where this guy is from. He's the drill sergeant in Bill and Ted's Bogus Adventure.
Oh, man.
Bogus Journey. I mean.
No, I know exactly what you're talking about. It was driving me crazy too. I was like, "That guy looks so damn."
His mouth, because he's got that big mouth and everything. He's just like teeth. Yep. So he's like Morton Downey Jr.
Yeah. Morton
Downey
Jr. Yeah.
The old talk show host. That's an old one, man. Cigarette smoking.
Oh, that's funny. Yeah. The big mouth. Yeah.
All right, cool.
Let's start the slaughter.
So I'm warning right now. It took me 3 times to watch this shit. The first night I watched it, a little inebriated, I had to shut it off. Like after 40 minutes, I was like, I don't even know what the fuck is going on.
I fell asleep the first time. I had to go watch it a second time.
Real slow.
It's just I mean, like,
the action lasts a minute apiece. Yeah. Literally, he gets to a fight, it's over in a minute.
Yeah.
They're like, what the fuck is happening?
And it's always like some stupid shit, you know, ain't gonna work in the street. Like, you know, it's like somebody's coming at him and he's just like pushing him. Like, it's like
pushing on him.
Seriously?
He has a couple of elbows and he has that one move. Where he...
Say, man, you seen this girl?
I seen the top of her head.
Yeah, that was his head.
That's good.
Hey! Oh! Jesus.
man. Stop this motherfucker. He's crazy. Where's my piece? He ain't nothing. Take him out. This motherfucker's crazy. Fucking Italian puke.
Freeze, motherfucker!
Come on, man. Not today, please. Put the gun away.
Smack she like yeah. chops you down and shit like that. That's cool. I give it. I give him that one. You know that way he grabs you into it and smacks you down.
The clothesline.
Yeah, the clothesline.
Cool.
You know, but everything else is just like a smack.
I literally was timing every fight, and every fight was like a minute long, and he would beat up six guys in like 1 minute. There was like there was no challenges at all.
Yeah, exactly. You know, like. So self-righteous in the beginning, you know, like, oh, you're protect the CIA and you're doing drugs. It's like, yeah, what the fuck
is that? So, yeah, that was my first, he goes through his life story, which is supposedly part of his real life.
Yeah, yeah.
He joined the gang when he's 17 years old.
Yeah, because they show him in the dojo, and he's talking in Japanese, and he's talking with an Italian accent. it's like, konnichiwa.
It sounded like a little Dutch of both of them.
No, it sounded like konnichiwa. I don't know.
Oh man, yeah, and you see all the masters like approving of him, like yeah, you know.
Good job.
But yeah, I don't know.
Some guy saw him. Well, the guy Nelson, Nelson Fox.
Yeah, yeah, recruits him. You know, it's the CIA.
And like, yeah, I said the same thing. I was like, first of all, I thought it was the Vietnam War. I missed that part, so I didn't know it was like after the Vietnam War. It's like 73 or something.
Yeah.
But I thought it was during the Vietnam War. So when they were torturing him, I'm like, fuck those motherfuckers. They tortured the shit out of us too. What the fuck are you complaining about?
Yeah, I know. He's like, that's not humane.
Then I missed again the first time I watched it. I missed that. He was saying that it was about the opium and all that shit.
Yeah.
This is what the CIA is all about, whatever.
Yeah, exactly.
My drugs. Why would I
get... And then it's like, I quit, you know? And then what does he do? He becomes a cop.
And goes into hiding too, apparently, because they're like, oh, as soon as I saw your name, I knew that somebody named Nico could have had to be you.
Yeah, right. It's like there's not too many names. Yeah. Nico.
Somebody named Nico.
So I've been looking for him. What took you so long to find him?
Oh, man. Yeah, you weren't looking too hard, CIA. He's like, we do foreign stuff. We can't find anybody in America.
Yeah, exactly.
You know?
So talk about the convoluted plot. All right. I'm going to try the best. We're just going to go right through it. So, so we can just talk about all the other fun stuff. So this is what I got out of it. So the CIA hires the drug smuggling gang to smuggle in, not drugs, C4.
Yep.
So they can kill a priest. So he doesn't tell that they're going to kill the senator. What the fuck? They went through all that shit. Just kill a fucking senator.
Yeah, right. Just get a guy that won't show up at the church.
Here's the other thing, too. That scene fucking when they're torturing the fucking priest with the truth serum.
Yeah.
But Henry Silva, he's too so fucking cheesy.
Oh, God.
So he just gives me saying, did you tell anybody you killed the senator? Because if you did, then we can't kill the senator.
Yeah. You're going to ruin our plans.
Father? I have had enough.
But father, I want you to tell me the truth. Can we kill him? If you told anyone about our plans to kill the senator, we cannot kill him.
It's messed up, man.
Yeah, this guy's kidding. He's like,
what did he? I think he gave him. He gave him like. Heroin is the
well, I think it was truth serum.
Truth serum, but what is
sodium pentanol?
Yeah.
Sodium pentanol?
All the 80s and 90s movies had that shit.
Although, apparently, you know, according to, you know, all those facts and myths that you find on the internet, that stuff don't really work and stuff. But it works in movies.
Yeah.
That's what they're using in the movies. You know?
Well, I'll just give you the quick plot. But it was just so couple, but you need it. And they pushed it all in 90 minutes.
Yeah, oh, man.
So you just, like, if you miss a second, you're like, what? Wait, why are we here?
That was only 90 minutes, that movie? Yeah. I thought it was like 2.5 hours.
Well, that's what it was. I got so bored.
Oh,
first
my
night.
God, it was so bad.
Because, like I said, the action is too quick. The longest scene is the chase scene.
Yes.
That's the longest action scene in the whole movie. Oh, and at the end when they're chasing him, when he hits the guy out to the window and you see the dummy.
Yeah. Oh, that was the best. He's like, oh.
Man, I got bad luck with cars.
Oh, my God.
You get choked in the beginning. The car.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And it's like, really, was that the best thing to do? I mean, what if the car didn't stop? He would have been,
It's like a slam of brakes, exactly.
You know, like.
My thing back in the day when I was on top of the roof. That's where I got it from. On top of the car. Like, oh, Steven Seagal did it. I could do it. I could.
Well, Steven Seagal did. He was driving.
No, he wasn't driving.
Yeah, yeah, because oh, you're talking about that. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay, yeah, yeah. I thought we were still talking about the guy falling off the bike.
Oh, no, 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 no. That was the end, yeah. So that was the part where I turned off, because now they're at the fucking the butcher shop, and I'm like, why the fuck are we here? Like, what's the reasoning for you? So the second time I saw her, oh, okay, so she went to go save his niece, or his cousin,
yeah,
who's doing crack.
Yeah.
And then her boyfriend tells him that, oh, yeah, there's going to be a sting or whatever.
Sting operation.
Operation. Oh, well, yeah, there's going to be a drug deal or whatever.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So it's like all that one little thing set up all this freaking
events. Not to mention the fact he just walks in and just starts smashing people's faces open and stuff like that.
Well, then he goes into the, yeah, when he goes to the bar to go find her. Michael Rooker. You saw him, right?
Yeah, who is that?
Michael Rooker from Guardians of the Galaxy.
Oh, yeah, 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 I saw him. Yeah, Yondu. Yeah, 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 yeah.
He was sitting, he makes one comment or whatever. I was like, oh, yeah. Also, the guy from Sons of Anarchy, the fat dude, he's like, he sticks his head out the window. That was his role. Like, what the hell?
Hey, man, everybody's got to start somewhere.
You know, he was in Batman. He was Think About Your Future.
Oh, yeah, 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 Eckhart.
Eckhart, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
He was that guy, too, yeah. But he was in Sons. He was, what's his name, man? The big fat dude. The real fat dude.
Yeah, yeah, well.
Anyway, and then supposedly Charles Riley, not Charles Riley, John C. Riley was in it.
Really?
Yeah, he was one of the thugs. I couldn't find him.
Well, I didn't even know to look for him, but I definitely didn't notice.
But those two, I definitely noticed. I noticed it first.
Yeah, I definitely picked that Yondu. That's how I know.
I also, when Nico's going to find this guy, and he gets, the gang comes out, They shoot the car. They shoot like the machine gun.
Oh, yeah, yeah,
yeah, yeah.
Yeah,
yeah, and he's like disappeared out the back. And like, yeah, now they got like yeah, 5 or 10 people with machine guns. Yeah,
everybody fucking cannot use a machine gun for shit.
With one handgun, like, everybody jump. They're like, shit, he's got us.
You know what? I give it to that one guy. He's like, you can't shoot all of us. Like, yeah. I was like, oh, okay.
I was like, I'm like, he's a cop.
But he's above the law.
Who ain't above the law?
Yeah, and then, you know, yeah, of course, and then he's got all his connections, so he's got these hideouts and stuff. His wife is sitting there begging him, look, they're just threatening us and sending pictures of us that they're going to kill us all. He's like, don't worry about it. They'll take care of it.
I got this.
A Sicilian.
Well, they set the bomb off in the church.
Yeah, that was crazy, man.
That was fucked up.
Yeah.
I was like, that was a little bit...
But again, it was very excessive just to rub out a priest.
A priest, exactly.
And it was like, you know, like a I don't want to say an immigrant priest, but, you know, an illegal priest, I guess. He's in hiding and stuff like that, you know? So it's like...
Refugee,
that's what I'm trying to think.
Oh, yeah, that was the other subplot, too. Like, they got all these fucking refugees. Like, well, how many fucking subplots can you get?
Well, he's a saint for them, too, you know?
Oh, my God, I'm telling you, man. I was just like...
He's going to save them all.
I needed, like, a chart.
Right? Like, CIA with the yarn.
Connected to this, yeah. All right, and this guy's connected to that. And the reason why... If I didn't watch it the second time, I still wouldn't know what the fuck was going on. Because I literally had to turn it off. I was just like, I don't know what's going on. I was like, I'm too tired. My brain is not working.
I can't. I thought it was just me because I thought it was just like I was just like switching off and then like kind of paying attention again because it just was switching so quickly that I'm just like,
it goes quickly.
I felt like I missed the transition.
This is how bad it was. I had notes, right? 2 pages, and I had to stop and I went to Johnny Dangerously.
Yeah, oh, man.
And then I went back to Above the Law.
Well, another bad part was, what's his name? Neil? Agent Neely? Agent Neely,
The FBI.
Oh, FBI.
Yeah, the guy kept trying to tell him to stand down or whatever. He's a menace.
He busted him with like a 15-year-old kid. 15-year-old girl.
Yeah, yeah, he's not even.
He goes, that's illegal in some states.
It's illegal in every state.
You keep hitting the table.
Sorry, it's not tight, that's all.
I'm like, dude.
Yeah, and that's your problem.
He breaks the wall. He's like, all right, that's it. Bring him to the beach. All right, now I'm going to treat you the way you treat me. Go jump in the water. Great.
Yeah, he was like, all right, I guess I will. Even when he's driving away, he's still like, ah!
Yeah, yeah. It's like, dude, you can stop, man. He ain't gonna shoot.
He's like, do it.
The big water splash.
So threw a bucket of water.
Exactly, because it looked like he didn't even jump into the water. He looked like he jumped into a little pool.
He jumped over the edge.
Yeah. Exactly.
That's when I said that part. So when they said, that's it, you're suspended. Like, your gun and your badge. I was like, now he has to go
now,
above the law.
Now, was it just me? Was there an audio problem? Like, when he slammed it, there was no sound. Did you hear sound?
No. I don't
remember. Okay, yeah, because I was just like, what happened? I mean, usually when somebody slams their badge in anger, you hear a boom or something, you know? But, yeah, I remember, like, when the movie first came out, we were like, oh, wow, it's so quick. But, you know, now that we're a lot more seasoned into the type of martial arts that is out there and, you know, and other action heroes like Jet Li and all that stuff, even Jason Statham, you know, you're looking at this like, I mean, Van Damme is someone I never really had respect for on the karate scale. Well, just because when it comes to, like, his movies and stuff like that, everything is like a... You know, like there's 2 second delay with every hit. Even like when he's gonna do a helicopter kick, he kind of sets it up for 2 seconds and then like one hit and then sits there. Trust me, now that I said that, go watch it. Go watch it. It'll be really fucking annoying. Okay. You know? So compared to that, it was just like, you know, but then you look at it, it's like,
oh, he is quick. He is quick, but he just doesn't do a lot. He's just pushing everybody.
He just keeps pushing everybody.
Oh, here's my thing is that. So I always had my own personal movies that I would watch over and over and over again by myself. Because usually, and that was my favorite. This was my favorite fucking movie.
Really? Above the Law?
I don't know. I don't know if it was 88.
I don't ever remember really caring for the movie.
I watched it all the time. And, I always put it on. And I didn't remember shit about it. And I was like, what the fuck did I like about this movie?
Don't you hate that when you ruin 80 movies that you loved as a kid and you're watching as an adult? You're like, what was I doing?
It's not a horrible movie. It's a bad movie. But, I mean, it's got good production value.
Yeah.
The acting is really pretty good. You know, a couple of lines that are really bad and Bradley said. The storyline, I mean, they crammed in a fucking cute. That movie would be a 3-hour fucking movie with a part two in fucking nowadays.
And Peter Jackson made it.
Well, now everybody's doing part twos on movies and shit.
Yeah, I know.
One thing that got me too, when at the part of the movie, at the end, they bumped Nico with the truth serum, right? Mm-hmm. He fakes it that he's choked out. Right? So then he snaps out of it, grabs the guy, breaks his arm, and then snaps his neck.
Movie's over.
And the movie's over.
Yeah, like falls into the middle of the meeting or something. And like, everybody's like, oh, God. Seriously, it's like,
I told you, man. 1 minute. You can use the stop clock, man. Every action scene in this movie is 1 minute.
Yeah, and you think as a karate action star, he would have kicked everybody's ass with karate.
No, he shoots everybody.
Yeah, with a keto and stuff. Yeah, he just shot everybody and then broke the one guy's
neck. And then, but this guy is supposed to be a top CIA assassin.
Yeah. He's like, you should have killed me before. Oh, I'm doing it now.
He'd have a little bit of fighting experience.
You know?
None of them have.
You know, I mean, even like Jean-Claude would bring out the big guy first, and then Jean-Claude would have a hard time fighting him.
Yeah, he'd get bloody and everything like
that.
And
then he fucking wins the match with him.
And then he comes, he rallies at the end, you know? Oh, man.
Yeah, I told you, there wasn't a lot that we could talk about this movie.
Yeah. And I mean, like, even if you try to research, like, you know, usually there's some fun facts that happen behind the scenes. So nobody had fun on that movie. There was no fun facts.
I cheated a little bit and I went to the IMDb trivia thing to see if it's got something.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, you know, I was just
desperate.
I was desperate, man.
You know?
Nico made me do it. they put in the fact that, like, Pam Grier said she really loved this movie because it showed her acting ability.
I was like, kept doing, complaining about getting to be in a damn.
It was a typical, you know. The acting was fine, but it was just like because she was acting the fuck out of Jackie Brown.
What you have to do is you have to actually look at when she made that comment, because was it made when she was promoting the movie?
That's true.
Because everybody says real nice things about the movie when they're promoting it, you know.
But nowadays, he's pretty much canceled. Like, fucking nobody wants to work with him. He's an asshole. They said he's an asshole. He's literally got that ego. Like, he thinks he's the toughest guy in the world. And he's not.
You even see, like, when he, like, even as an old man and stuff like that, doing demonstrations for people.
Oh, and he's fucking huge now. The thing. He was so skinny in this movie.
He really was. It was insane.
Holy shit. And you can see his hairline starting to go away.
Yeah.
Before he started putting a marker on it.
Oh, man. But, you know, and you could just see him, like, just being a dick, like, hurting people just because they're letting him.
And I don't usually condone, you know, making fun of people or whatever like that. But he's a dick.
Yeah.
We hear everybody says he's a dick. He was a dick up the six.
Something tells me we're going to have a guest star on our next podcast. Louis getting his ass kicked by Steven Seagal.
He's going to bust open shit. You got something to say about my character? I work really hard on my character.
You think my Akito's fake? I'll break your wrist.
Like, here's a burger. Go get it.
I'll be right back.
Well, yeah, the cast of Saturday Night Live hated him. Like, Lorne Michaels said he's never coming back on the set again. Yeah, he was a real dick. And there's just look at what movies he's making now. Like, he doesn't even, they're filming from like the waist up now. He doesn't even do, like, they do everything like stuntmen do his job for him.
Yeah, like ridiculous. 90% of the movie is shot from behind and stuff, and then you'll just see him standing there like, so you want to fight? And then it switches to like space balls. You see the guy with the mustache and stuff and the tattoos.
The one guy that really hates him is John Leguizamo. He talks shit about him all the time because he worked with him on
He made a movie
Executive
with him, right?
Decision.
Yeah.
Executive Decision with Kurt Russell. They had to get into the plane.
Yeah.
And they had to get into the plane, and Steven Seagal was in it for like 10 minutes, and then he died. He's like, he's like, himself, whatever. So what are we going to... I put down Orange Cassidy. That's how he reminded me of how he fought, because it was just like, he was so like...
The way he was running, they had a bad run.
You know, I mean, you got Tom Cruise, like one of the greatest movie runners in the world.
Yeah, right, exactly.
Nobody runs like Tom Cruise, so everybody else is bottom.
Yeah, right.
So, how are we going to do the rating on this one? All I kept thinking, too, is like I wanted to see the one with Alpha Justice.
Yeah.
And the whole movie was just, anybody seen Richie? You see Richie, you tell him I'm coming for him. Anybody see Richie? No, the whole movie. That's it. Looking for Richie.
Fucking voodoo magic, man.
No, that's Mark for Death.
No, just said?
No, Alpha Justice.
Oh, they're all the same.
How about C4?
There you go, C4. There we go.
A smuggled C4.
Dead priest.
We're canceled before we started.
That was such like he was trying
it's
to be
so boxing. Random.
No, but it was such like a Rocky. He's like, to his father. He's like, the priest says, you better come here. Or I'm gonna tell your mother. He goes, yeah, you know, my mom loves you. Tell her to call. She could deal with a call from you or something like that.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, just trying to be down to like Sylvester Stallone.
Like, everybody loves me.
Everybody loves Nico. All right, C4. I think C4. We could do it. That makes sense. It's a bomb.
I'm sorry, but I'm gonna give it 2. If you had 2 T-Boy,
don't let us cloud your judgment. don't feel pressured.
I did the same thing. I watched it. I thought it was gonna be great.
Yeah.
I remember?
No, that's how I remember it too. I was,
and it was like the fighting scene. Okay, all right. And I'm like, damn, man, damn. And I just like, I give it 2 T-Boy. I can only watch it that one. I can't watch it again.
I watched it twice just to watch the beginning again because I was drunk.
Yeah, you know what? It was like an extra $2 to buy it, you know, instead of rent it. And I was like, I still don't even want to buy it. I don't want to own it.
I know, and I did that with like Survivors. And Survivors was like $2 extra to buy it. So I'm like, I'll buy it.
I might as well put it on my catalog and stuff. But that one, I was like,
This one, I only paid $10 and it was a 3 movie. So I was like, all right. And I really did have high hopes for this one.
I might have just paid the $10 for Under Siege.
Under Siege, I'm going to cut the side.
I was going to say, unless that gets
I remember Tommy Lee Jones was the bad guy.
Yeah,
he was pretty crazy in that one.
Yep.
All right, what do you give it?
I'll go with the two C4s, just like Chops. And the only reason why I'm giving it 2 instead of 1 is just because you got to give respect to the classics, you know, like to the people who started it, you know. So, you know, these were the beginning of the action heroes and stuff like that. So, you know, I feel like, you know, without Steven Seagal, we might not have some other, you know, action karate heroes, you know. So I give him the respect, you know. No? You don't think so?
I don't know.
I think those genres are starting, and then, you know, then they gave whatever that guy
was. You got Chuck Norris.
Was Capoeira, you know, they gave him a chance, and they, you know, like.
Well, you know, Chuck Norris started in the late 70s after Enter the Dragon. Bruce Lee, you know, obviously started up the Kung Fu thing. I mean, you could be right. You could be right.
Yeah, but that was just like a karate movie.
I can't argue with it.
And, you know, Chuck Norris is doing like military movies, right?
No. He only did the three.
Okay. I mean, no, he always did
a cop movie, Hero and the Terror. I love that one. That's
good. Oh, Hero and the Terror. Yeah, yeah.
What was the other one? That was when he fought the dude from Superman, the guy Superman 2, the guy who doesn't talk.
Oh, okay.
And there was another one too that was like that too, where he fought this giant fucking genetic fucking beast or whatever guy, killer, serial killer. The Octagon, which was sick. That was when he did the ninja movies. Good Guys Wear Black. Code of Silence. But anyway, I mean, yeah,
that's Chuck Norris, man.
I can't argue with you. I can't argue with that. You might be right.
Yeah. I mean, I'm not making an official quote or anything. No, I'm just saying
it's a good statement.
I could see it.
Yeah. All right, man. This is gonna be my lowest score, man. I'm surprised. I went 1.5, man.
And, wow, 1.5.
And I only gave it a 0.5 for Pam Grier. I was highly, and I watched it twice too. So I said maybe the second. And I just couldn't, like you said, it's out of my system. It's out of my life.
I learned my lesson. Now move on.
Yeah, like I said, I got hopes for Under Siege and Under Siege 2.
Yep.
I remember Under Siege 2 being decent. Catherine Heigl was in that one when she was a kid.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, so that was like one of her first movies or whatever.
No, okay.
Yeah, and that's all we got to say about that.
Yeah,
nice short one.
Yeah. Hopefully the movie clips will keep this.
Don't forget to subscribe and hit that like. Tell your friends about us. Tell your family. And good night.
See you next show.